video, we will cover a quick overview of phylogenetic trees, including the basic steps to build a tree and to manipulate the tree viewer in Genius Prime. Phylogenetic trees are used to infer evolutionary relationships among sequences. Genius Prime can build phylogenetic trees using distance, maximum likelihood, or Bayesian methods. Before you can build a phylogenetic tree, you need to align your sequences. To do this, select all of your sequences and choose Align Assemble and Multiple Alignment. We will use the muscle aligner for this example of HIV sequences, as it is suitable for a medium-sized dataset. Select Muscle Alignment from the Alignment options and click OK to start the alignment. It may take several minutes to complete. Once you are happy with your alignment, select it and click Tree to open the tree building options. At the top of the tree building options, you'll see the available tree building algorithms. This includes the built-in Genius Tree Builder and Consensus Tree Builder, and any plugins you have installed. The built-in Genius Tree Builder produces distance trees using either neighbor joining or UPGMA methods. In addition, there are a number of plugins available for producing maximum likelihood, parsimony, or Bayesian trees. Each tree builder has a different interface for specifying the evolutionary model and other parameters. Before you embark on building your tree, you should familiarize yourself with the principles of tree building and the strengths and weaknesses of each method. In this example, we'll use the Genius Tree Builder to build a basic distance tree. We have set the genetic distance model to murine and the tree building method to neighbor joining. We'll also set an outgroup, which will be used to root the tree. And we'll calculate support values using bootstrapping. Click OK to start your tree building. When your tree has finished running, a new tree document will be created, and it will automatically open in the viewer. By default, Genius displays trees in rectangular or rooted layout, even if the tree is unrooted. Options for circular or radial formats can be found under the General tab, along with the zoom controls. If you wish to change the root of your tree, click on the node of the taxon you wish to specify as the outgroup and click Root. To flip the position of taxa vertically without changing the topology, use the Swap Siblings option. The controls at the top of the viewer also contain options for the color and font sizes on your tree. To color an entire clade, select the node at the base of the clade and select Color Nodes. In the controls to the right of the tree viewer, you can choose which field to display on the tips of the trees. For example, name, description, organism, or accession. You can also enable display of support values and branch lengths. To view the underlying alignment for the tree, click the Alignment View button above the viewer. Changes that are made in the tree view will also be reflected in the alignment view. For example, if you color nodes in the tree view, these will also be colored in the alignment view. The blue arrows next to the sequence in the alignment view denote that these sequences are linked to the original source sequences. This means that any changes made to the source sequences, for example editing the name, will be propagated to the alignment and the tree, and any changes made on the tree will be propagated back to the source. Visit our Resource Center for more hands-on exercises and tutorials.